All right, that was Aerosmith, a little live Adam's apple. I'll dedicate that to the late lamented, not that she's dead, but the lamented and gone Melissa. Yep.
Did she have an Adam's apple?
No, but she could eat it. But now, it just, we haven't mentioned Christmas yet. We haven't done a couple of things. We haven't mentioned, and how actually, I'll tell you, though, the last couple of gorgeous women I saw when we were out at the club, they did have Adam's apples. So actually, I might have to just broaden my horizons a little bit, Tony, because I'll tell you, you know.
It's all right, George.
Yeah, my philosophy from here on in is going to be, if it looks gorgeous enough, I'll bang it.
Whatever floats your boat, brother.
Once again, as I mentioned the other day, there's nothing worse than when a transgendered person looks better than half of the actual women that I have slept with.
Yeah, that's not a good thing.
Or when half more skilled with makeup and everything, too.
Yeah, or when half of the actual women you've slept with have more hair than the transgendered. Yeah, that's unsettling too.
Yuck.
Yep. But anyway, like I said, we haven't mentioned Christmas. Now, we didn't, you know, we did handle Christmas on Chuckles, your show, but we haven't mentioned Christmas here yet. We haven't mentioned Star Wars here yet.
Nope.
Is there anything else obvious we haven't mentioned here yet?
No.
Except maybe horror movies and music.
All the usual stuff.
Basically. Everything having to do with what the show is supposed to be about. We haven't mentioned a damn thing.
Right,
yet,
it's a typical haunted cabaret.
It's a typical haunted cabaret.
And we're halfway through.
Yeah, and we're halfway through. All right, let me think. I was just before the show talking to Tony Jones, and we were complimenting Joe Moody from Danger Studios about helping me work up that really awesome introduction to the show, you know, in which we call the haunted cabaret the home of all things horror, and we have all those awesome effects and everything. Maybe we should do something having to do with old school horror for a couple of minutes, I'm thinking.
I love old school horror. Did you see the gift I gave you, right?
You did.
Old school horror, the blob.
Yes.
As a snowman.
Yeah, it's a hand-painted ornament from Chuckles the Clown adorning the room even as we speak. A green, and what would my suggestion was a green gangrenous snowman. Not so much a blob, but a gangrenous snowman. Which actually was kind of, that's kind of a good idea for a movie or story.
The Abominable Gangrenous Man?
Something. Yeah, it kind of looks like a snowman, but it just, it's nasty.
Turns green and eats you.
Yeah.
It's almost like
once again,
face.
Speaking of half of the women I've slept with.
Ew, Tony. Yuck.
I don't, Tony.
Where have you been?
Where hasn't he been?
Oof.
Tony Jones has been places that give him nasty flashbacks from time to time.
Wow.
That's, yeah, I mean, it happens in war. Why shouldn't it happen?
It happens in your sex lives, too.
Why shouldn't it happen in our sex lives? I mean, just like, I think I've told the story before, but I can't tell it now because it's FCC.
Four words. Wednesday night, club hell.
There you go. Or,
$1 PBRs. Yeah.
Or any of my longtime listeners, you know, from back in the days when this show went over the air on BOB, when we were uncensored, I just say dirty sheets, just to evoke that nostalgia of some of the traumatic sexual experiences I've had in my past that helped make me who I am today.
How's this classic car? How do we get off this? How?
Well, we could go from perverted sex to H.P. Lovecraft really easy.
Oh, yeah.
I've done that. I mentioned Lovecraft. I mentioned the rats in the walls.
Yes.
Didn't I?
Yep.
Okay, we got it covered.
Yeah.
All right, so should we do more classic horror?
Yeah, darn right.
All right.
Darn tootin'.
All right, in that case, the first thing I'll do is recommend our listeners to check out 13 Folds Magazine, Dave Death's, you know, high-quality publication. And I don't know what that noise. What was that?
That was me trying to operate a computer. I broke it.
Okay.
Chuckles versus technology.
The important thing about 13 Folds Magazine, though, is that, Tony, I believe it's both online and in the print version, there is a story of mine as
right,
we speak.
Yeah. 13folds.com to get it online. To get the actual physical version, you have to get it from the folks at 13 Folds are one of us. So it's the actual magazines are a pretty rare find.
Right, but the actual but the entire content of the magazine
is online. I taught them well.
Right, so if you want some traditional horror, you can go to their website, wherein you will find a story of mine written with my own two hands.
Which, you know, in true cannabis-loving form, your Halloween story, your horror-related story is still setting up there close to the new year. Right. But I digress.
Of course, that was planned. That was planned because you'll notice, if you read the story, that it is actually a Christmas ghost story. It was contained in the issue of a 2 or 3 months before because, you know, people are going to take a while to get around to it, you know, in an intoxicated state. But
you read a paragraph at a time.
Right. But all the more so, if you haven't been to that website, if you haven't read that issue, go there. If you want classic horror, check out my story and the rest of the magazine while you're at it. It's a good read. Okay, so there's some classic. Well, it's not classic horror because I just wrote the effing thing, but it's in the tradition of, how's that? In the tradition of classic horror.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Now, the other thing is, on Chuckles' show, we were discussing, you know, Christmas horror movies.
Lots of them.
Yeah, we hit on most of them. You know, check out Chuckles' broadcast. We hit on most of the Christmas ones. So maybe what I'll do is I'll just say, okay, we'll leave out the Christmas part. And the holidays are a time for ghost stories, horror movies. They are a time for horror. And just like we were talking about on Chuckles' show, Christianity has very little to do with Christmas. It really does. Yeah. I mean, we have that big Norse loci worshiping Christmas tree, you know, on December 25th, because December 25th is actually a Scandinavian Norse religion holiday.
It also breaches on the paganism holiday for you're starting to count down the days to plant.
Right. Right. So. That's right. That's why actually the Catholic Church or the Christian Church put the birth of Christ on December 25th. It was an attempt to
mask out.
Exactly. Good. Yeah. Good choice of words. Cover over the original pagan traditions. You know, they knew they couldn't get rid of them.
So because, they might as well use them themselves.
Right. And back then, if you tried to get too insistent about a wimpy religion, the Vikings would basically get one of those big axes and like dismember you, like show you the error of your ways.
Yeah.
So they had to be a little more subtle.
Yeah.
And so, you know, that's why we have Christmas on December 25th. True story, by the way. This isn't just blasphemy for its own sake. I mean,
right. We're not trying to get you mad and burn crosses in front of our yard. This is truth. Truth hurts. And that does too sometimes.
Just hurts your nasal passages.
Every now and then, there's something about, now, I don't know if it's a, speaking of classic horror.
Tony Jones skid marks?
Well, it's not so much Tony Jones. It's the chair that Tony Jones sits in at the control board over there.
That absorbs the stench?
No, that's Nurse Misery, you're out of your depth here. Let me just enlighten you for a second. What we have here in this studio is a case of an influenced piece of furniture. Okay, we have...
It's haunted.
Well, I don't know. To get farts like that out of Tony Jones, it might even be demon-possessed.
Wow.
I'm not sure if I'd stop at haunted.
He keeps that stuff up. The Germans are going to be able to rent him out for a gas chamber. You're not going to need pills in the next experiment.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, is that... Yeah, we'd have to ask your friend Keith Johnson, the demonologist. But it's people that become possessed. But now, am I correct that objects can become influenced, or
objects can contain energy that draws stuff to them? Now, they can't become possessed,
right? I know that, right?
But spirits and demons can be attached to certain objects, like maybe the fart in chair,
right? Now this chair, for example, you know, we salvaged this from another part of this old mill complex where we have our studio. We don't know the history of that chair. Let's say, for example, that old chair was in, say, the apartment of somebody that died horribly, right? So you're saying that the psychic energy could be associated with that chair.
Right.
And the psychic energy of that event would lure lure a demonic influence.
Now, what I'm told from the history of this mill is that this was the human resources area. So maybe somebody sat on this very chair in the mill days, knowing they're going to be fired, right. knowing that they lived in this mill housing, which means they also lost their house when they were fired.
Right. They were sitting in that chair when they were handed their notice. They took a heart attack and crapped the chair and died.
And that very energy runs through me.
I'm just saying it's probably a residual haunt that he keeps setting over that keeps possessing him.
Right.
The residual haunt's probably some guy that ate a lot of beans.
Right. Maybe just a high fiber diet.
And he's getting his activities through him right now.
I think a message from the Lord God is coming through again.
Oh, no.
The only thing residual about the chair and Tony's flatulence would be the stain in his shorts. There is some serious residue from that.
See, I did bring up the skid marks, and they were thrown under the rug. Like
okay,
nothing.
So what you're telling us is that there is no... This is just the Tony Jones disgusting, nasty habit carried over from childhood. There's no demonic influence here?
I am not confirming nor denying the possibility of there being some...
Supernatural
otherworldly,
influence.
Supernatural, paranormal...
Le Taco Bell, man.
Flatulence spirits possessing Tony Jones and the chair. However...
Here comes the smell.
thankfully, my nasal passages have been burned out from many thousands of years of pestilence.
Yeah, okay. While we all take shelter, never mind that. While we all take shelter, let's go back to the music. We are Born of Hate, Genocide SS, here on the Haunted Cabaret on Rhode Island Free Radio. Everybody duck.
Good God. You need a fucking dead horse.
All right, that was a little hardcore just to get you head banging. You know?